Hello, my name is Mário Marques da Silva. I am an associate professor at the Universidade Autónoma de Lisboa and the director of the Department of Sciences and Technologies. I'm also a researcher at Instituto de Telecomunicações in Portugal. The title of my talk is The Evolution of 5G Communications. So, the main reference for this talk is on the 5G and beyond, published in Applied Sciences MDPA last October. A second reference for this talk is Project Management in the Fourth Industrial Revolution, published last January. So the outline of this presentation: first, I will introduce digital transformation, then 5G communications will be addressed. The future evolutions of 5G, as well as non-orthogonal multiple access, will be covered. And finally, an introduction to 6G communications will be given. So, the digital transformation. What is the meaning of digital transformation? There are different digital transformations. In the past, we lived the so-called the third industrial revolution, which was also a digital transformation. Right now, we are living the fourth industrial revolution, which is a different digital transformation. The third industrial revolution, also known as information age, because people used to be bombed by massive quantities of information, was characterized or started with analog electronics in the 40s, and then the digital electronics in the 80s, and finally the third step was based on all over IP. This means that television signals, internet signals, different telemetric signals used to be sent over IP. Voice over IP as well. Everything used to be over IP. So the third industrial revolution was the revolution of the computers, the information systems, and technologies. Right now, we are living the fourth industrial revolution, also known as the revolution of automation or the new digital transformation. This is the knowledge age. There is a difference between the knowledge and information because knowledge is the right information at the right time for the right person to support a decision making. So this is much more useful than information because being bombed by huge quantities of information sometimes is not good because it can be viewed as noise. So, the fourth industrial revolution is characterized by the replacement of humans by machines, humans by robots, by the massive use of artificial intelligence, by massive use of big data, and by massive use of Internet of Things. So, things communicate instead of humans. So, similar to the third industrial revolution, the fourth industrial revolution allows a more efficient use of the resources. So, the society, the organizations tend to be more efficient, as well as human lives. So there is a huge modifications of the society. Naturally, that some jobs disappear and others are created, and there is the need for humans to adapt to this new paradigm. Instead of well, with the fourth industrial revolution, most of the decision makings that used to be done by humans tends to be done by machines, by robots, by artificial intelligence algorithms. And in this sense, more advanced skills are required by humans, such as scientific, technical, and human skills, critical spirit, emotional intelligence, abstract thinking, and others. So, the fourth industrial revolution comprises massive Internet of Things. Well, the 5G communications gives a very strong contribute. So 5G is very determinant in the implementation of the fourth industrial revolution. So the 5G communications is disruptive. Why? Because this comprises because 5G, while previous generations, the different evolutions between the second generation to third generation, or the third generation up to fourth generation, the differences were mainly higher speeds, higher bandwidths, and slightly lower latencies. The 5G communication is disruptive because this supports Internet of Things, machine-to-machine communications. So we have two cars, for example, communicating directly, and there is communications can be, while in the past communications used to be always implemented using a base station, nowadays with 5G communications, do not need a base station to implement the communication. So they can the things can communicate directly. Machines can communicate directly without going through a base station. So 5G communication supports speeds 20 times higher than 4G communications, up to 20 gigabits per second, and the latency 10 times lower than 4G. A second aspect that is important in the fourth industrial revolution is the big data. What is big data? Big data is massive quantities of data, structured or not, which can be processed by artificial intelligence algorithms to generate the knowledge and to support or to decide or to make decisions. And for example, a car can be viewed as a robot with four wheels, and a car moves, but has to make decisions: speed up or brake, turn left, turn right. Who has right to go before the my car or the other car? So this robot, which is a car, uses artificial intelligence and collects data, massive quantities of data, big data, and this data is collected using Internet of Things. And 5G is very important in such communications. So the fourth industrial revolution is very important in different areas. It comprises a huge transformation in industries and agriculture, but in defense as well. We see here the Predator, which is an unmanned aircraft vehicle, armed with sensors, which can be remotely controlled from the other side of the globe. We can use, for example, micro drones. In terms of logistics, there is big differences because we can have trucks unmanned trucks or autonomous trucks. The fourth industrial revolution also includes smart cities, smart houses, or medical or lawyer advices using artificial intelligence instead of humans, autonomous vehicles. So there is an impact in terms of in different areas of the society, in mobility, in health, in defense, research, many different areas. So the 5G communications is very determinant for the implementation of the fourth industrial revolution, namely in for the implementation or to support autonomous vehicles. A vehicle for to be autonomous needs to communicate with the environment, not only with the other vehicles, but also with infrastructure, vehicle to vehicle. So different types of communications around the vehicle comprises V2X, vehicle to everything, namely vehicle to vehicle, vehicle to infrastructure, vehicle to pedestrian, V2P, and V2N, which is vehicle to network. So for a vehicle to exchange or to share huge quantities of data, such as position, direction, speed, point of origin, destination, the traffic that surrounds it. So the technologies that support all of these are two most important. Millimeter waves, which is carrier frequencies around 60 gigahertz, and MIMO systems. MIMO systems means, namely, massive MIMO, massive MIMO. Massive MIMO means that MIMO stands for multiple input, multiple output. It means that we have multiple transmit antennas, multiple input, and multiple receive antennas, multiple output, MIMO systems. The carrier frequency is around 60 gigahertz has a great advantage because this supports a much higher coherence channel bandwidth. Supporting much higher, consequently supporting much higher throughputs. The problem is that the range achieved with such communication tends to be limited. So the future of mobility relies on car sharing, and car sharing, the future of car sharing, is naturally burst by autonomous vehicles. So in the future, either I buy a car and instead of having a car parked in the garage for 90%, 95% of the time, either I buy a car and I share the car, I use the car for 5% of the time and I share my car for the remaining time, or I simply use the car of the others. 5G communications. As I mentioned, 5G is disruptive as it comprises communication between machines. It supports the communication between machines and relies on massive Internet of Things. The 5G communications among the different services that are supported by 5G communications, in order to allow services resilience, improved resiliences of services, three different groups of use cases were created in 5G concepts. One is entitled Enhanced Mobile Broadband, which is, let's say, the similar concept of communications through a base station, in this case using speeds 20 times higher. In this case, 5G communication supports up to 20 gigabits per second of communications, and the latency 10 times lower, 1 millisecond. This Enhanced Mobile Broadband relies on traditional communications of higher speed. The other group of use cases is entitled Ultra Reliable Low Latency Communications. So, this is used, for example, to support the communication between vehicles or remote surgery. Ultra reliable means that the communication cannot fail. It presents a very high, extremely high reliability. And low latency means that the communications is almost real time. So these two characteristics aim to avoid accidents, naturally accidents of cars, or that the surgery is performed in a very reliable manner. The third group of use cases is entitled Massive Machine Type Communications and relies on massive use of Internet of Things devices interconnected with 5G communications, namely for the implementation of smart cities and smart logistics, and for industries, for example. So in this case, What is important is capacity. Capacity is the target, not reliability, not low latency, but capacity. We need to have many, many devices, and for these in the future, as the number of devices increase, we will face a problem of spectrum to support all of these devices, and there 5G needs to solve some problems to mitigate this limitation. So the roadmap to 5G communications, we expect to have three different 3GPP releases. The first initial implementation of 5G is based on 3GPP release 15. 3GPP means third generation partnership project, and this standard was released in 2018 and relied on the improvements of 4G, namely on enhanced mobile broadband. So enhanced mobile broadband, where the aim is mainly coverage and capacity. So we are speaking about the traditional cellular communications. In 2020, we had released the 3GPP release 16, which relied on the implementation of the two other use cases, namely ultra-reliable low-latency communications and massive machine-type communications. Ultra-reliable low-latency communications relies on mobility, low-latency, security, and reliability. Communications between vehicles and or for surgery purpose. While massive machine-type communications, we are speaking about smart cities with a high connection density, deep coverage, and ultra-low energy consumption. So devices with a duty cycle very, very low, they communicate very rarely. So the new air interface entitled 5G New Radio is also defined by 3GPP release 16. Finally, by 2022, we expect to have 3GPP release 17 implemented with several improvements to 5G, as improvement to ultra-reliable, low-latency communications, improvement to the network slicing, improved capacity, remote control of vehicles, etc. So the two most important issues or characteristics or techniques that support 5G communications is by one side millimeter waves. Millimeter waves means that instead of the traditional 3 gigahertz frequency bands used by previous generations, 5G communications also use upper part of the spectrum, up to 100 gigahertz. And this means that, why is it called millimeter wave? Because the wavelength of these carrier frequencies is the order of millimeters. So by using a higher carrier frequency means that the channel coherence bandwidth is also higher, which means that the throughput that is supported, the data rates that are supported are much higher. Nevertheless, the range, the propagation losses are higher, which means that the range achieved with such communications are also lower. An advantage of this, since the millimeter waves have wavelengths of the order of the millimeter, means that the antennas are also normally a function of the wavelength, which are also of the order of millimeters. In this case, so this corresponds the other technique that supports 5G communications is entitled massive MIMO. What's the meaning of MIMO? MIMO stands for multiple input, multiple output. Multiple input relate to the propagation channel. Multiple input means that I have a transmitter with multiple transmitting antennas. Multiple output means that I have a receiver with multiple receive antennas. So I have different flows of data being transmitted by different transmitting to different receive antennas. This allows sending multiple parallels flows of data, increasing the throughput made available to the user. So these two issues, millimeter waves and massive MIMO, are two issues that support 5G communications. So why massive MIMO? MIMO is what I have just mentioned. Massive means that the number of transmit antennas and receive antennas is of the order of hundreds or even thousands of antennas. So 5G communications, the main limitation of wireless communications is that as we increase the throughput, as we increase the data rates or the throughput, the symbols rate, the inter-symbol interference also increases. So this is not only a matter of spectrum, because if we have more spectrum, we have more inter-symbol interference, which is, let's say, the biggest enemy of wireless communications. So how can we solve this problem? One of the measures, there are several mechanisms. Two mechanisms were already mentioned before, millimeter wave communications and MIMO systems, where we had different parallel flows of data. A third technique that is employed by 5G communications is called OFDM. OFDM stands for Orthogonal Frequency Division Multiplexing. So in this case, instead of sending, for example, 10 or 4 gigabits per second in one bandwidth, we split such bandwidth into small subcarriers, and each subcarrier sends 1 gigabit per second. In this case, we have 4 times less inter-symbol interference in each of these subcarriers. So as we split a bandwidth into multiple subcarriers, the level of interference reduces. So if we have, for example, 100 subcarriers, the level of inter-symbol interference decreases 100 times. Naturally, the problem is that the complexity increases. So in practice, OFDM is not implemented the way I have mentioned. It's implemented in a more complex manner, using inverse discrete Fourier transforms and discrete Fourier transforms. And a cyclic prefix is added to each block, such that the inter-symbol interference is avoided. And this inverse discrete Fourier allows that different subcarriers are partially overlapped without creating interference, and this allows a more efficient use of the bandwidth. So MIMO techniques I have already addressed. So we have different parallel flows of data. In this case, we also split the data into from serial into parallel data, such that inter-symbol interference is also reduced. So there are different techniques that are utilized by 5G communications. The two most important is massive MIMO and millimeter waves, as well as block transmission techniques, namely OFDM. So millimeter wave communications includes frequencies much higher, and higher frequencies present higher propagation losses. So this is typically mitigated by using massive MIMO techniques, such as beamforming, to concentrate the energy towards the target. And therefore we can achieve a higher distance with our link. So, in terms of future evolutions, when we speak about billion of IoT devices, we have a problem because we have no spectrum to support all of these communications. Therefore, future evolutions of 5G need to incorporate techniques to solve this problem. One strong candidate to solve this problem is the adoption of NOMA. NOMA stands for Non-Orthogonal Multiplexes. Non-orthogonal multiplexes means that different users, we have, for example, a base station, and we have a closer user and a closer terminal user, a mobile user, and a further mobile user. The further one requires higher power, and the closer one requires less power being transmitted by the base station. Therefore, since signals arrive with different powers, the successive interference cancellation procedure can be implemented in order to taking advantage of the re different received powers, separate different signals of different users. So this is called non-orthogonal multiplexes and is a strong candidate of future evolutions of 5G communications to solve the problem of the of spectrum. There are two different techniques. One is regular NOMA and the other is cooperative NOMA. Cooperative NOMA means that the closer users detect and retransmit a copy of the signals to further users, such that further users beneficiate from from diversity. And therefore, as we can see, cooperative NOMA achieves a performance in terms of ABU over NO, or in terms of bit rate as a function of bit energy per power spectral density, much better than regular NOMA. Finally, 6G communications. So the 5G communications focus on the initial requirements of the fourth industrial revolution, while 6G communications expected by 2030 aims to improve such implementation of the fourth industrial revolution. It is worth noting that every 10 years we expect one different we had one different generation, the first generation around 1980, the fourth generation around 2020, and the sixth generation around 2030. So this sixth generation aims to consider new services not completely covered by 5G communications, such as augmented reality and extended reality, artificial intelligence applications, holographic services instead of having a video teleconference. Holographic service can be viewed as a 3D video teleconference, improved autonomous vehicles, support of flying vehicles, and increased mobility, among others. Finally, it is worth noting that the foreseen requirements for 6G communications includes nomadic peak data rate of at least 1 terabit per second, energy efficiencies up to 100 times better than 5G, and the spectral efficiency, that is the number of bits per second per hertz, up to 10 times better than 5G. And how to achieve such requirements? While 5G communications achieve the existing requirements mainly with millimeter waves and massive MIMO communications, 6G relies on visible light communications in terahertz band. Finally, I would like to take this opportunity to advertise a special issue entitled that I am invited editor of this special issue. The subject is Massive MIMO Systems for 5G and Beyond, Latest Advances and Prospects. And the magazine is Applied Sciences from MDPI. And I finally would like to share with you my five books published with CRC Press that relate to the topic of this talk. Thank you very much for your attention.